Welcome back to Minimal Effort Gardening on 420 TV. What you're looking at is previously on last year, I had overgrowth of tomatoes everywhere, tons and tons of tomatoes. So the problem we were facing is we had a big incoming storm there in late November, and it was going to freeze everything, so we had to set up and recycle some lumber that was laying around the yard and repurpose it for a temporary greenhouse, and we did end up saving most of the crop. And you can see here, we just built temporary, you know, kind of cover for it for the snow. I had a fireplace there, also had some lights and an electric heater, and we ended up saving the majority of this, which was hundreds of pounds of tomatoes. And that was sweet. So this year, of course, we're going to be doubling down. Hopefully we won't have to deal with that. A little more planning this year, I think, so we don't have to deal with this and get these tomato plants up and going early. And some of the other crops, then we won't have to deal with all the snow and ice. And hopefully we'll have our entire crops ready to harvest next time we get this kind of weather. So we're about to start setting up. And as you can see, I went over it, and a lot of the plastic we put over some spaces collapsed because of the weight of the snow. But for the most part, we saved everything, and you could see there were still flowers on these tomatoes in late November trying to bloom and make new tomatoes. Anyway, it's a new year, and we're going to try to quadruple our effects with the minimal effort garden. So we're here on 420 TV, and look, I scored an ass load more free wood, a little bit of fencing, some tubing and stuff, so all kinds of good stuff in here. Planks, probably got enough to make me a small fence now, and I got these landscape timbers. I might even make me a shading area for my garden here, which is under the way of construction right here, with some more free stuff. That was free. It just dragged it off of somewhere. We got all kinds of stuff we have to kind of burn, but I can go through there and cut some good boards, and then we have all of that stuff. So all kinds of building materials for free. Some over there. So we're going to try to quadruple down on the gardens. As you can see, I got some stuff already kind of growing on its own. All these flowers. But I got me a whole walking onion patch right here, and then next to that are a bunch of garlics that are popped up, and then over there is some other kinds of onions that look like they're about to bloom already. And I've been using these plastic tubs kind of, because they were already out, and there's some cilantro over there too. Sweet. So we're germinating. I got them outside because it's nice and warm right now. So this is the first start here. Plus, we already got a lot of stuff growing over there. You and I got all this crazy project going here. We scored a bunch of wood, which is awesome. I'm going to make a fence out of this stuff. And some more beds. So this was all free wood right here. And then we got a bunch of firewood out of it. So I probably cut in the tomatoes from last year, right before this video. So yeah, and we got all this junk. I've been collecting junk all winter. Just not junk, but spare wood. We got firewood. We got buckets. We got all kinds of stuff. I already soiled out this one. This will be the tomato bed. I'm going to try to keep it just in one spot this time, because we had so much and it kind of killed everything else by the end of the year. So what's cool is, though, is we already have a bunch of walk-in onions that got kind of beat during the winter, but you can see they're kind of got a really big head start, and there's some little scallion onions, I think they're called, or whatever, the little ones right there. I forgot that you can't get too close with this camera, but anyway, so we got a bunch of stuff already growing, lots of flowers. Oh, here I got spinach already growing up from last year. This cilantro was seeded from last year, and because I was putting these little plastic buckets over it, it kind of launched up, so we got a head start. You can see some little lettuce already. And I haven't planted anything out here yet. This is all from last year. Here's another walking onion. No, I'm sorry, this is red onion. That came from the dinner table. We just sliced off the end and threw it in there. And some more little onions trying to grow there. But anyway, so we got that for free. So we're going to make a whole little area of herbs and stuff in the yard with that stuff. And then a bunch of, this is really cool stuff. I mean, this was free. Right here. So we're going to make a fence out of that. Here's some, lots of good timbers. A couple of them are, you know, a little crooked, but we're still going to use them. And then these, I'm not really sure what they were used for, but we kind of separated what was, you know, half decent out of it so we can make stuff. But this is my main project, which is kind of a sad story here, because my grandmother, my late grandmother, was actually going to hook me up and pay for the wood, and I was going to do it, and I put it off for a week because I had some other work to do, and I went and did that work, and then she passed away. So it looks like it's going to be ghetto fabulous, but I've already collected probably enough 2x6s that are decent enough to replace the ones I took out of here. As you can see, this was under my deck here that used to look like this, which was getting really old, and the rain from up here was just rotting it away, plus termites over decades. And the people that lived here evidently didn't really treat the wood. So this time we're going to really treat the wood. Some of it made it. I mean, this is the original wood right here. And it's just like brand new, minus a couple termite holes. But they have long since died, so it's pretty solid. And then we're going to replace this whole deck mostly with salvaged wood, unfortunately. But, you know, it's something to stand on. It's better than a sharp stick in the eye. And actually, we were thinking about maybe ending the porch here, and then putting over here some tubs that will be kind of inside like a greenhouse, and then we can grow some food inside too, maybe even in the winter. And if the laws change in New Mexico, we may just be growing a little something something in there, you know what I'm saying? And our hollyhocks are all, you know, starting to go, so this whole thing will be filled up with hollyhocks again soon. And we're setting up our work table. So we're going to use all of this free material this year and see if we can't make an even bigger place to kick it with lots of plants. So we're going to fill up back here with beds. And you can see we got a lot of extra wire and fencing and stuff. So by the middle of the summer, I'm hoping to have a whole fence around this area. There's Lawson, my helper, up there. And bunch more beds, so not just these that we started with here, but more beds over here, some over there, and some back here. And this bed right here that we scored, it's kind of under the lumber, you see that's old-timey looking bed headboard. We're just going to put a bottom on there, and we're going to move it over there, and then we're going to make this a big giant potato bed, literally. So we're going to fill it up with soil and sand at the bottom and put some gopher mesh or landscape cloth or whatever they call it on the bottom, so we don't have the little critters munching, because they like to actually go after these yuccas and around them, because it collects water, so they'll be in the yard again. Yeah, no problems with this last year, because I had that's one thing I did spend money on, is that. And oh yeah, here, this is a piece of someone's deck here that we just went and picked up, so that's all free wood right here too. This was from a different score, and now I got me a walkway. We don't have to walk in the mud when watering. So this is all coming together pretty good this year already. Minimal effort garden. Oh yeah, I forgot to mention, everybody's out buying mulch. Look at this kind of good mulch right here that's free. This is all the old tomato plants right here. This is all the old plants from last year. We saved them. We just broke them up. So they're making a lot of good straw, and when I was digging in here earlier, I was finding potato sprouts already. So that's cool. Already got potatoes growing up in here. And yeah, I use this for mulch everywhere. So we reused it. This is all the old squash plants. Somebody was an asshole and flicked a cigarette butt in there, but hey, whatever. We'll take that out of there. But yeah, we got all this free mulch. We're not going to buy no mulch. Wood chips, free wood chips, and all the plants you had last year. And here was these okra stumps. Look at them. They look like wood. And we just cut those and let them stay there and rot, which will be great. Oh, ooh, another little lettuce is popping up right there that I didn't plant. Some barrage from last year. That's kind of cool. I even saw a carrot over here. Ooh, what's this? Potato? I didn't even see that last time. Got a couple potato plants growing right there. There's a carrot. And I didn't even plant nothing yet. This is just stuff left over from last year. So really, we probably wouldn't even have to do anything out here. And there would be a bunch of food growing just from the seeds from last year. Lettuce seeds, tomato seeds. We're going to really try to ramp up the chilies this year, though. So I'm going to try to, like, fill this whole thing right here in the middle that's got the big onion, the cilantro, with a bunch of chilies and see how we do, because they kind of like the shade, and there's this wall right here that'll help that out early in the morning. And then we plan on maybe building some kind of shade for some of these plants and making buckets. I saved all these buckets you can see over there. So we're going to start putting plants in the buckets so we can move them around. So give them a lot of sun, then give them some shade when they're getting beat by the July sun, which is going to be god awful probably by that time. But so far it's been nice, cool, and I'm even expecting one more freeze, so we're not getting too excited yet.